Hi, this is a demonstration of student faculty document sharing system. So this is an efficient system that allows for student faculty communication as well as document sharing using Android application plus a web interface. So this system allows the student to upload download documents easily. It may be assignments or other timetable or any documents that the faculty and students want to share with each other. The system allows them to share these documents with ease, and it only shows respective documents to respective students. Suppose a particular year student sees only the documents he is needed to see, and thus it makes it easy for the faculty to share document to required students, and they can download it and view it from home as desired.
Let's see how the system works. So this is my student application. We'll open that. And here I get two options of login and one for credit. In credits, you can just add your name or your faculty name or your supervisor name. And let's see the login system. So let's enter my ID and the password, which is provided to me by admin. So I'll say login. And this will take me to the home page where I can get the details about educational notice, forums and general notices. So let's see the educational notice first. So when I click that, I will get another home page for that. It would include different sections of engineering, so I can click any of my concerned topic. And let's say computers. In that you get options for selecting the year. So let's say if I am in TE, and I will get option to select the semester. So let's say this one. And after that you will get the bunch of places or bunch of options to select from, like syllabus, notice, assignment, experiments, notes and question paper. So if there is any notice in this section, it would show the data, or if there is nothing present, it would say no data present. So let's see the section where some notices has been uploaded. So let's say this one, and you can see that we have a question paper over here. So if we click it, it would be downloaded into the system, and you can directly refer that from here. So it would open in your phone directly, and you could refer it. So this is how student can access the notes or the PDF or other things which admin has uploaded. If I select B from here, that is the last semester, you would see that those students get an extra option for aptitude test, so which is a questionnaire kind of thing which they have to fill, or a test or a sample test kind of stuff. So user can just select any answers for the question and say submit. So this is how a user can practice for his test. So if we go back, and if we select semester 7, you can see that this option is also available in semester 7, but not in 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So if we go back again, others are same as the computers. Next we have is discussion forum, where a student and admin or the different student can just communicate, and it's a kind of group chat kind of thing where you can just provide the details and you can ask the details from your classmates and all. So that's a great help for the users. So if I go back again, you can see that there is a general notice kind of thing where admin can post the details or post notices like tomorrow is holiday or result day or something like that. So you can see this, and if you click one of this, a PDF would open and mentioning the notice. So if any function or any event is going to happen, admin can just post on this particular section, and all the students would get to know about that particular topic or the notice or the event. So this is how a student module can work. So let's see the admin module. There is the admin homepage where he needs to log in into the system with its own ID and the password. So after logging in into the system, he can get an option to add a student, upload books, upload exam notices, upload the general notices, adding some questions to the question bank, and viewing the reports of the particular stuff, and he can view to the discussion forum as well. So let's see the Add Student module. So so here admin needs to enter the student name and selects it its stream, say IT, comms, EXTC, civil or mechanical engineer, whichever it is, and he needs to enter the phone number. So let's say my name is ABC and I'll select the stream as comms and the phone number, and you need to click on add. So this will add the student into my database, and from there student can access its application with the ID and the password which he receives. So next is upload books module, where admin can upload the book for a particular stream in a particular year. So let's say I select comms and say year BE and HSAM, and type this is the subtype or the type of the PDF I'm uploading. So I'll select experiment, and name is SAM8. Experiments. So I will say choose file, and I will select the PDF which I want to upload. So let's say this one, and I'll say open and click on upload to add that particular book or the PDF into the section. Next we have is upload exam notices. So you need to select the type of a notice, like it's a timetable, it's a result, or it's any notice kind of thing for exam purpose specially. And we'll enter that name, SAM8 exams, and we'll again choose a file and we'll say upload. And this files can be accessed by the students by using their application. So next is upload notices, where admin can upload any notices regarding the events or any function or anything. So next is upload notices, where admin can upload the details of any events or any other thing going through the college. So we can just say the document name and choose the file for that particular event, and see upload, and it would be also added into the database. So next we have is an add question section, where admin can add the questions for last year's students. So you need to just select the stream and enter the question over here, and enter the four options and the correct option over here. So let's say if my question is like this and my options are like this, and I will say the right answer over here. So if my correct answer is D, I will enter the same thing over here, and I will say add. And these questions would be added to the user, and they can attempt them and improve their skills. So next we have is a view books module and report section, where admin can get all the books which he added into the system and access them from here. Next is view question module, where admin can get all the questions which he has added into the system for particular streams. So if I want to search for any stream lights like let's say I want to search for comms specially, I will select that particular stream and I will say search, and I would only get the questions regarding the comm section. Next we have is view students, where admin can get the details of the students, the ID, name and streams and the phone number. Next is view result module, where admin will get to know the results of particular students who has attempted the aptitude test or the test which they appear from the application, and here are their marks and the date of the test. And the final module which admin has is discussion forum, where admin can chat with the students and they can just provide any details or any confusion which he needs to solve or anything. He can just communicate with the students, and it's same like a group chat, you can say that. And you can see here that its chat has been came up over here. So this is how the student faculty system works. Thank you.